Dear Annalie, it was so nice to see you again. Your kindness and perspective never ceased to amaze me. It was so interesting to learn that you were the custodian of Aunt Florence's records. Maybe that is why you always remind me of her when you speak. She was such an inspiring lady, wasn't she? You asked me if there were any anecdotes about the spring gatherings in my grandmother's journals that I could share with you. I knew I would find several. There is one in particular that I think you will like and that will serve the purpose perfectly. For Chloe and I, it will be the first time, so I am sure everything you prepare will be absolutely wonderful. But I can understand that you long for that charm and magic so characteristic of the order's origins. So here it is. I hope you enjoy it. Something I've always admired from Aunt Florence is that she has the same determination to work hard as she does to celebrate. "Don't ever let life be a dull business," she will say while decorating the table elaborately for no other reason than life itself. So, before the spring festival of the Green Folk, Aunt Florence invited her friends over for tea to plan for the big celebration. We decorated the hidden room with colorful flowers, fabrics, paintings, and gemstones. We baked some biscuits and a cake. It was a celebration in itself. By the end of the meeting, we had all agreed on the theme of the fair, and each of us had been assigned a task. Bonnie Rose and I will be part of the organizing committee with Aunt Florence and the other young girls. We will be in charge of building the stalls and the resting area and gathering all the dishware. The festival will consist in four parts: greeting, activities, dinner, and dancing. During the greeting, Aunt Florence will welcome all the members of the Green Folk and say a few words to honor nature. Several cold delights and beverages will be served on the small tables. Agatha and Cassandra will sew an embroidered bag for each of us to carry all the materials for the art lesson and the rest of the activities. Becca and Olivia will prepare the warm dishes for the evening, which will be served at the main stand. Julie will take care of the dessert table, and Hayden will finish the decorations and collect herbs and flowers for the flower crowns. Cassandra will regale us with her harp, and, as always, we will close the evening while dancing to the rhythm of the violins, the mandolins, and the waving bonfire.